Hello, and today we're with Rick Lutlightweiler, who is the Chief Operating Officer, President of Utell Hotels and Resorts, as well as COO of Pegasus Solutions. Good morning to you, Rick.
Good morning.
Rick, social media, tweeting this, that, the other. Do you tweet?
I do. I have both a personal Twitter account as well as a Pegasus executive Twitter account.
Right. Hotels, a lot of them now, they're venturing into this realm of social media, possibly some of them without understanding it fully. How is it impacting your business?
Well, especially from our Utell Hotels and Resorts representation business, it's an important part of our advice and service that we provide to the hotels because, again, I think a lot of people they have their own personal frame of reference about those things, and they, oh, I don't need to Twitter. I think it's a waste of time, or Facebook. Oh, my privacy is more important to me than that. And so they wrap that around the business, and that's a dangerous thing to do because whether an individual is engaged in those services or not, the rest of the world is. And so what we're advising properties on is how to understand how those technologies, those tools, those services work to impact your business, understand the differences by region because they're pretty vast, and then how to use them effectively in your business to maintain your image the way that you want it to be, to build it up, to build brand recognition, and of course, most importantly, to bring in more room nights.
You mentioned that it's different by region. What do you mean by that? How do things differ by region in terms of Facebook and tweeting? Surely it's all up in the cloud, isn't it?
Well, it is, but the interesting thing, and I was here in part this week for Web and Travel, which takes place the first part of this week and then ITB the later, and it was very interesting to see some of the panel discussions, and as an example, Facebook absolutely dominant in the US, 50-60% of people using it. Suddenly you look at Tokyo, and it's under 10%, and there's another version of that social media that is bigger. And then you move to China, and actually, unless you have special virtual private network access, you can't even get to Facebook. So in that case, you really have to understand that if I'm tapping into those markets because they're a feeder market or because that's where my hotel is, I have to understand what works in that market, how people use it, which tools they're using, and then how can I best leverage that? And even within that, culturally, what's appropriate within those tools? And so it's a fascinating and very quickly evolving part of the business.
Is there a possibility that this would negatively impact your business? Because obviously Facebook and Twitter's, they could run promotions. AirAsia at WIT said that they possibly don't need the media anymore because they have all thousands of fans.
Yeah.
Is there the possibility the same thing could happen for a hotel? They have so many fans on Facebook that they don't actually need to use Utell or some of your other services?
Well, it's of course, anything's possible. The biggest part for us is we are very focused on evolving with those trends. So actually, a new line of business for us just a year or so ago was getting into that level of support for someone so that we can help them. We can help optimize their website so that it makes full advantage of those social media type services. We actually have a tool that we can provide so you can monitor all of those types of channels. So TripAdvisor, Facebook, Twitter, anything that somebody is saying about you or your competition on those channels, you can see in one window and you can see how you're performing. You can actually respond to individual comments about your hotel. So truly, if we sat back and didn't evolve, then certainly we could find ourselves in a less significant place in the market. But of course, that's not our approach, so we're moving out ahead of that and really making sure that we're staying ahead so that we can help the people we're serving stay ahead.
With this solution, do you supply to the hotels like an interface? Like you mentioned there that, for example, that you're monitoring the different tweets, the different Facebook comments, all these different things. Is there an actually easy to use interface that the hotel, they can see everything in one position? Is that what you're providing in terms of the solution?
That is one of the solutions, yes. So there's both consultative support where we sit down face to face and talk them through strategies. There's also a tool, it's called eBuzz Connect. And by using this tool, you actually do get on a simple single screen a view of all of the ratings, all of the comments from all of those channels, and you can see how your scoring is comparing to your competitors. And that way, so you're not only able to manage, you're seeing, well, what's happening? What are people saying? Is it going up? Is it going down? Is there something I need to respond to? You're also seeing it in comparison to what's happening with your competitive set. And that allows you to understand, are you moving up or down, not just on your own, but against the competitive set that you're most focused on?
Very interesting. Have you also been able to implement booking technology into this solution as well?
Well, that particular tool is really more about monitoring the social media and helping to manage that. Within the booking capabilities, what we usually work with the hotel on is, how do you make sure that when somebody comes to your website, they can book, they can comment about their stay through those sorts of social media, and through those sorts of social media, can you get them to perhaps connect you to other potential guests? So, you know, if you become a fan of that hotel on Facebook and suddenly all your friends see, oh, I'm a fan of the Amara Hotel. So now I have the ability to outreach because, of course, we rely in this industry sometimes on the advice of others. Mostly what we trust is the advice of others that we know. And so that kind of connectivity between a social media that, oh, I see that this person likes that hotel, this person liked the newly renovated rooms at the Amara. Well, that has a different impact than just an ad that says, come see the newly renovated rooms at Amara. So that, I think, is the power of the media and that what we have to help people take advantage of.
Right, in a way, using very much the Amazon system, I think they were possibly one of the first to start it. Mm. Those people who read this book also like this book.
Yes.
In terms of the booking, are you able to implement an actual booking engine into the Facebook pages of the hotels, or has that not quite evolved yet?
Well, it is possible, and we have seen some do that. It's a little bit more sophisticated, and I think part of it is people are trying to figure out where is the right timing for that. But certainly on your Facebook account, you can have that sort of capability where you can link into what would be a booking window. And then the other thing that you can do is, as we're getting more and more into the mobile apps so that you can download on your iPhone or Android or iPad, those apps are getting to be very multifaceted as well, so that you could have somebody doing Facebook and being able to book and being able to comment. So it's all coming together very closely.
Right. You mentioned the mobile applications and what have you. How far advanced is Utell in terms of the apps that you offer the hotels? Are they able to literally, as you say, make a booking today through their
mobile devices?
Yes.
Yes, actually, Pegasus was one of the very first in the entire industry, and Utell Hotels and Resorts. So we've been able to provide online mobile device website booking for 4 or 5 years now. And so what we've been really focusing on is taking that to the next level. So we're enhancing the usability of that, making it a little bit easier, customizing it for each hotel or hotel group so that even though it's the Utell mobile booking application, really it looks like the Warwick mobile booking application. So that way it's very customized to them. It's not our tool, it's their tool. And that's, I think, the future is what you'll see is that continue to be enhanced so that it becomes even more user-friendly, more capable, more connected to the social media and such. And then the other key is going to be making sure that once you've checked that box, you have your own, how do I as a hotel take advantage of the sites and the apps that are out there that are across hotels? Because at some point, as an individual user, I may love the Amara Hotel, and so I'm so committed to them, I'm going to have their app. But am I going to have 50 different individual hotel group apps? Maybe not. So I'll only have that for the ones I'm really most passionate about. And then as I go forward, I'm going to be really focused on the apps that can give me the most service and the most cross hotel of my interest connectivity. And that then is going to mean, as a hotelier, how do I make sure I'm represented well there? And so I think that's the next evolution that we're going to be focusing on.
Right. In terms of the e-buzz that you mentioned, how much would this cost for a hotel? Because obviously, again, hotels now, they're trying to cut costs left, right, and center, charging for this and doing whatever. But they're concerned about cost. How much would it cost them to implement something like that, to be able to receive the information that you would supply through e-buzz?
I think probably the best way to think of it is it's about the equivalent of one booking per month. truly. I mean, because it does differ different around the world and how you choose to use it and how you choose to implement it. But if you look at an average daily rate, an average two-night stay, if that's appropriate, really one booking a month that you increase because of this, that's about how much it costs.
Right. In terms of the languages that you support, do you cover all of the major Asian languages?
Yes, we have the capability to cover all those languages, and it's really up to the individual hotel or group to decide which are the most important for them to leverage.
Right. In terms of advanced technology, in terms of, for example, translation, mm-hmm. for example, one of the problems, if you're Japanese, you might not understand English, and yet mm-hmm. a lot of the reviews are in English.
Yes.
Are there any systems in place that you work with at the moment or that you're looking at that would automatically try and translate a review that was written in English originally into another language so that somebody else would be able mm-hmm. to benefit in Japanese or in Korean, for example?
Well, we do have translation services that we make available. For the most part, those are not instantaneous. Frankly, I think there's a lot of tools out there that you can use for the instantaneous, but the quality is a little suspect. And, you know, just the wrong kind of interpretation can leave you with a very different understanding of the intent. So today, the message comes through as it was written. So we can facilitate that, we can get that translated. It'll first be translated automatically, and then we have an expert look at it and actually make sure it's correct. So we can provide that service. Or, of course, many of the hotels actually have the ability to do those translations themselves. So either way can work, but I kind of caution a little bit about relying too much on the automated piece so far, because I've just seen, especially in this region, a few too many concerns with it.
Right. We mentioned numbers before. With Facebook being so new, people have a tendency to perhaps become a fan of this, become a fan of that, and before they know it, they're fans of everything.
Yes.
And they get bombarded, obviously, with a lot of marketing messages from the people mm-hmm. they're fans of, which basically ends up diluting the whole process. How do you personally, how do you manage your fan?
My fan list?
Yes.
I actually am pretty choosy about that because of what you just said. You know, I really, when I think about that, I think, well, who do I really believe in and want to support? That's really a big part of it for me. Because I not only think about what's going to come to me, but I'm thinking that I've just endorsed this. And I'm endorsed it to all the friends that I have on Facebook. And so I want to make sure that I really feel good about it. And so I'm pretty choosy. And then I have no problems turning one off if it annoys me. So I think that's something that really people need to think about. It's a trust that someone makes that you will respect their, you know, time and their privacy when they become a fan. And certainly, if they become a fan, they're interested in some that you have to say, but you can wear out your welcome. So I think it's you have to be smart about that.
Excellent. Well, on that note, Rick, thank you very much for your time today. I do appreciate it, and have a safe trip back to America.
Thank you. Always a pleasure.
Thank you.